say, our upgrade pace is looking solid right now, but I do think we need to push harder if we want to stay competitive. Here's the report.
Here we are, live in Montreal at the Circuit Gilles Villeneuve, where the teams are making final preparations before today's practice session gets underway. In 1999, the outside track wall, situated on the last corner of the lap, ended the race of three Formula One world champions, Damon Hill, Michael Schumacher and Jacques Villeneuve. Since then, the wall has come to be known to fans around the world as the infamous Wall of Champions.
Turns 13 and 14 are definitely the most demanding corners on the track. A quick chicane section, entering at over 180 miles per hour, drivers use plenty of curb and get very close to the wall. But hitting those curbs at the wrong angle can easily put the car offline. You'll see a lot of drivers bail out of committing into turn 13 using the escape road to avoid contact with the wall.
Quick look at the classification at the end of the session then. Here are your top three. Hamilton, Rosberg and Sebastian Vettel. That's it for practice then. We'll see you again soon.
How are you? I'm just passing on your qualifying goals for this weekend.
Good afternoon, and we hope you're ready for an exciting qualifying session as the teams make their final preparations here in Canada. When it comes to getting lap time out of this circuit, it's traditionally been about maximizing top speed. Do you simply remove as much downforce as possible, hang on in the corners and max out down the straights?
Top speed is a key factor for this circuit. Even if you can achieve the same lap time as someone running less wing than you, chances are you'll find overtaking difficult if you have too much drag.
Thank you. we're really pleased.
So qualifying is complete and we're all set for an exciting race tomorrow. Your top three are Hamilton, Rosberg and Kimi Raikkonen. The grid is set then, so that just leaves the race itself. Join us tomorrow, where we'll be live with all the action. And until then...
How are you? I have some information on the race goals you should keep in mind.
There is, as I look out of my commentary box window, a very large and very excited crowd here today, eagerly anticipating another memorable race. Lewis Hamilton took his maiden win on this circuit in 2007. Jenson Button came from last place to win here in 2011. And there's certainly no shortage of drama on offer here at the Canadian Grand Prix. If you want flat-out racing, you've come to the right place this weekend, as it's full throttle for 59% of this 2.7-mile circuit, peaking at around 210 miles per hour going into the final chicane. But that speed requires discipline, and there are more than a few close walls here just waiting to punish drivers with a heavy right foot. It's a favourite for fans and drivers alike then here in Canada. We're used to seeing the unexpected happen here. And with me today to enjoy it all is Anthony Davidson, a man who knows firsthand the surprises that can pop up in this race.
I do indeed. I had a good chance of some points here in 2007, but unfortunately it wasn't meant to be. My old colleague Takuma Sato, though, he managed to finish sixth, so the team took home three valuable points, and that was a big boost to everyone at the time. I'm not sure I can think of anywhere else that so consistently provides the kind of late race excitement we get here. Obviously, towards the end of the Grand Prix, the brakes are getting worn, maybe the weather situation has changed, so there's a lot to keep fighting for all the way up to that final corner.
We're performing really well so far this season. Keep this up and you'll be the team's number one driver in no time.
So before the off, let's remind ourselves of yesterday's qualifying session with a look at the starting grid. An immense lap from Lewis Hamilton yesterday puts him on pole position, and Nico Rosberg completes the front row. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Raikkonen, Vettel, Daniel Ricciardo, and a Haas. Bottas, Verstappen, Grosjean, and Felipe Massa. Kvyat, Perez, Nico Hülkenberg, and Sainz. Alonso, Button, Marcus Ericsson, and Felipe Nasser. Wehrlein, and Harry Anto, Kevin Magnussen, and Jolyon Palmer rounds off the grid. Now it's almost time to lights out, so let's go down to the track.
right. The start sequence will begin as soon as the grid is formed. Be ready with the clutch. Officials have enabled DRS. DRS is now available. To remain dry for a while, we will update you if the outlook changes. Some information on Perez. They have an issue with their car. They're going to be slow. Our gap to first place is 3.0 seconds. The gap to teammate is 6.8 seconds. has opened. Just entered the pits. Roman in the pits. front does appear, then we'll let you know. Some information on Bottas. They've got a serious car issue. It looks like they're retiring. Okay, gap to leader, 3.4 seconds. Okay, the safety car is out. The safety car is out. We need to form up at a reduced pace. Keep a close eye on that delta time. Make sure to keep it positive. Some information on Perez. They're speeding up again, so I expect they've fixed whatever the problem was. Slow down. Your delta is negative, which means you are too fast. Reduce your pace. Right, pick up the pace a touch, please. We need to close to within 10 car lengths of the car ahead. to go racing again, the safety car is in this lap. When the field accelerates, remember, there is no overtaking until the green flags. Safety car, in this lap. DRS is now online. There's 5 laps of fuel remaining. This is your final lap of the race. Driving. That's the race win.
Brilliant stuff from Haas today. What a superb victory. Anthony, what do you think made the difference here?
Well, I'd say it's just raw pace, plain and simple. I mean, we could sit here and talk about strategy all day, the overtaking, looking after the tyres. But at the end of it all, if you want to win, you need a package that's got the speed over everyone else. And that's exactly what they had today.
Our drivers are making their way out for the podium celebrations. And it's going to be Haas picking up the winner's trophy. Congratulations to the entire team for coming out on top in that amazing Grand Prix. And now let's take a look at the driver standings. It wasn't the best weekend for our championship leader, and their advantage at the top has been reduced. Moving on to the driver of the day then. Anthony Davidson, who would you go for?
I'm going to go for Marcus Ericsson. He's clearly got a very delicate touch in close proximity to other cars, and he's matured a lot over the past few seasons, which served him well today.
And here's how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. Mercedes have extended their lead at the top of the standings. It was also a strong Grand Prix from Haas F1 this weekend. Fantastic work from the American team to move themselves further up the table. There'll be plenty more twists and turns to come this season. I hope you can join us at the next race to see just who will come out on top.
Emma here. I had a sit down with the executives today to talk about your progress. Long story short, they're happy. Keep it up.